video, I'll show you the secrets of accelerating a small deposit using examples. I'll also explain the basic principles and rules. This video will actually be useful not only for beginners, but also for people who have already traded, increased their balance, want to return to trading, or are already experienced. It's also useful for traders, since the basic rules can help with larger accounts too. Moreover, I have a friend who applies various strategies to her large balance, dividing it into several parts for different strategies. It's also possible to grow these small parts of the balance to significant sizes. So I switched to Bybit recently, and the first thing I did was move my small trading account here, which I announced on Instagram, where I primarily communicate with my audience. Not many comments are written on YouTube due to the prevalence of bots, but on Instagram, you can follow me using the link below and send any questions in a private message. I will reply to all of them. Not many come in, but many have asked.
И много просили, Артём, ты показываешь счета большие, у меня нет столько денег, вот у меня есть $100, $300, $300, $1, соответственно, пополнил на отдельный счет и показываю в Инстаграме, то есть в реальном времени, в реалити-шоу, и первый результат уже есть, в принципе, на Ютубе тоже хотите поделиться, если будет просмотр, будет активность, буду продолжать. Что касается первых результатов по текущей сделке, пройдёмся позже, я совершил всего 4
трейда, 3 было
плюсовых, 1 был убыточный, и плюс $687 с 300. Давайте по порядку разберем каждую сделку. Вот они здесь зачислены. Каждому из сделок объясню, что было к чему. Они были все примерные.
I try not to engage in questionable transactions where I'm unsure.
Сомнительные сделки, там, 50-50, в которых не уверен. Они все были хорошие. И начнем с первой сделки, Ethereum Classic. Она все-таки дала основной буст to the balance.
I earned $400 from it. Заработал я с нее $400.
Все трейды я совершаю на фьючерсах, никаких там спотов, никаких плечей на спотовом рынке, никакой там маржинальной торговли. Только фьючерсы, только бессрочные фьючерсы к USDT. Что ж, Ethereum Classic, давайте найдем эту сделку. Откроем маленький таймфрейм, я все это дело высматривал. Кстати, нет, вру, не все это дело высматривал на пятиминутке. Вот этот трейд конкретно был, по-моему, на часовике. Или даже на 4-часовике. Давайте на 4 часа глянем. Нет, это было часовик. На 4 часах ничего интересного нет. Вот, buy, sell. На Bybit все так достаточно удобно указано. Видно, где купил, видно, где продал. Также можно историю ордеров открыть. Там будет также история отмененных ордеров, где я ставил стопы, тейки будет видно. Из интерфейса, кстати, не очень понятно, да, чтобы посмотреть отмененные ордера. Вот что касается тейков и стоп-лоссов, вот они тут в отдельной вкладке. Здесь конкретно
the fact
то,
that
что
I opened
я открывал
trade, take profit, stop loss
вот
can be seen.
Стоп-лосс можно увидеть.
You should be able to see this. What was the logic of the trade?
Какая была логика трейда?
We can see where I bought and where I sold. Let's go to the usual trading view interface.
Привычный, интерфейс Here I can draw. View.
And these drawings will remain for a long
time.
On a 4-hour interval, I have a setup pattern here.
У меня здесь как раз вот он сетапчик паттерн.
We ignore the right side. Here I had a buy. What happened? I traded at the exit from the downward wedge up on a 4-hour interval. The price had consolidated above the moving averages. It signifies an important level, after which we can record the switch from a downward trend to an upward trend. Ascending lows are present, very powerful bullish engulfing. So the price went beyond the level, stayed there for slightly less than a day, began to sell off, a retest of this level happened. The market was quite strong that day overall. The idea coincides with the overall trend on the daily time frame. Here it is, the exit from a huge downward channel. Consolidation is also above the moving averages. You can also see this level, consolidation above this level, which looked like a retest on the 4-hour chart. So I went into buy. Let's go back and look at the stop loss.
Давайте зайдем обратно, посмотрим
на стоп-лосс. Stop loss is 18.84, which means I set it at this mark.
Стоп-лосс 18.84, то есть я его ставил на отметку.
I placed the stop loss here under this level.
Под этот уровень я размещал стоп-лосс. То есть здесь buy,
stop
here, stop. Давайте
Let's go back to Bybit and see what we find.
Bybit. И что мы видим?
Here it is,
вот он buy,
selling at 18.84. It was right here behind this stop level. The stop is quite short.
Короткий.
Additionally, I check whether it's written here about the volume I took on which leverage.
Объем брал, на какое плечо.
I believe I had taken the 10th leverage
сюда.
Here.
18.55.
18.55 history.
Торговли.
In the current P&L orders, you can see a closed P&L of $400. The commission is 1.6. Well, I paid more for financing. The leverage isn't written well here. So this is what I closed. Yes, you can see the closed P&L and positions quantity. I took 150 Ether
Classics.
Yes, you can multiply to calculate the volume. In my opinion, I took the 10th leverage there on a whim. It's hard to say. Yes, okay, it was probably the 10th leverage. I managed to take it, weighing down only a little lower. My secret was lower. Where was it? The average entry price, the average exit price, here it is, 22,326. So I fixed it, by the way, almost at the maximum,
22,326.
It was a take. I didn't fix anything manually. It was the take. The deal lasted 4 days, in my opinion. I used it on my main balance, took the 5th leverage, and earned $7,000 from it. Significantly, I used it on a small balance as part of this experiment. Firstly, I made a clear exit beyond the level with a retest. Everything coincides with the general trend and the exit from the wedge. Very good, very approximate entry point. Short stop loss is short. Even the 10th leverage could have been taken here in 4 days. The trail sat just above the level of the previous high, as you can see. It responded by taking off. I could have set it a little higher. Of course, it rolled back immediately, but then it would have reached during the time of these 4 days. There was strong volatility throughout the market. Traders' emotions were running high, but this didn't affect me. This squeeze took out many within the day, those who trade. I conduct training. I have a group there with about a dozen other traders. Throughout the day, I see how it is there, who is trading, who is being affected, who can endure. Many were taken out by this squeeze. It went quite low on the others also. My price just reached the entry point. I was at break even. I didn't move the absolute stop, didn't touch it. Everything was clear.
Все четко, спокойно
calmly sat out, waited. There was a head and shoulders pattern, but the stop loss theoretically could have been moved under it here, and it wouldn't even have been knocked out. I didn't move it. It's quite lovely. It looks like it does, but on a small frame in a very bullish market for other coins, there were no reversal patterns. There was simply increased volatility. They bought up all of this long squeeze. I just sat and waited out this type of head on shoulders. Let's move on. Here, the diamond pattern, it's clear it doesn't always work out. Well, this isn't an example, because if there was an approach like this, it would matter. But here it doesn't. You see, after it, the price didn't fall, that is, after the bearish ones.
Пример бычьего рынка. Хорошая сделка, ровно по тейку, ничего особо не двигал. Идем дальше. То есть здесь уже с $300 получилось P&L 400. Я, кстати, только что калькулятором посчитал. Мне очень удобно, что объем здесь не пишет. 150.9 эфир классиков по этой цене перемножил. Там чуть меньше $3000 получается. Это было как раз 10-е плечо, да. И вот $295 я, получается, в сделку внес с 10-м плечом. Это вот такой объем.
Well, plus 400. We've already got the $700 on the balance.
Получилось на балансе.
Let's move on. I made a deal on the throne.
Я сделку провел по трону.
By the way, I now have a current deal on the throne.
Актуальная сделка по трону.
I'll tell you about it at the very end. First, I'll show you the current one. Right here, TREX, USDT, and here also it was approximate.
И здесь она тоже была примерной.
Here I had a buy, here a sell, and it was a trade on a smaller frame.
Сделка на меньшем фрейме. Эту сделку я давал
I broadcast live as part of our training. We call up once a week and our curators broadcast too.
Там у нас кураторы вещают. Я тоже
I also broadcast as part of the call directly. The Ether, my folks and I took this trade. A bottom formed in this 5-minute period, a double or triple bottom. It doesn't really matter. The bottom was throughout the entire market, and we surveyed all the coins in that moment. I won't switch now. But you can look at other coins on this date. I saw how altcoin began to shoot, how Bitcoin also ascended. The volatility in Bitcoin was within the flat altcoin. It rolled down and showed itself sluggishly, and here the moment began. Just boom, I saw the strength in the market and abruptly seized the initiative on the call, showed the throne. It had not yet flown away at that moment as the price approached here. For the same RD, for example, it had already shot vertically vertically at many other coins. The cartridge still also shot vertically. The level had not yet been broken, it has just been broken. I entered this trade. As for the trade, it is slightly different on this chart from what is drawn on TradingView, because it so happened that I showed this approximate trade as part of live training, where there was a take. You can see it was a stop, but I didn't place a take on this balance, because the trade was very reliable. The throne didn't really fly along with the market. The market went harder. I decided to leave it the next night, it closed manually, either the next day or one day later, this happened. Let's see, you see, I don't have any art here, so I am showing you the balance line here. I only fixed it manually when they started selling already. On December 7 we had a trading session, and on December 9, 2 days later, I saw that they started selling. I closed with my hands, didn't move the stop here. It was theoretically possible to move the stop here, but I decided to close immediately, not wait for the level to break through. I would have even been closed here a little lower, by the way. Not the best exit point, as it turned out. Then from this flat, a sharp fall began. I left early, and the students left early. They locked in place. It was very reliable.
Ученики вышли пораньше, они зафиксировались по
I decided to take a little more risk.
Очень надежно, я решил чуть больше рискнуть, тейк не ставить. Теоретически могла цена уйти по тейку, если бы меня не закрыло, да, уйти потом вот так вот вниз и выбить меня по стопу.
But I decided to take a little more risk in general. How to accelerate the balance? Let's go. I wanted to share secrets, but we'll go for a breakout then, that is. But you need to come to terms with the fact that you will have to take a little more risk. Well, the balance needs to be accelerated, that's right, 2 or 3 a year from a small balance will not allow you to buy a Lamborghini. That's right, you need to catch more movement, take bigger shoulders. And what is this? It's a greater risk. So I took a little more risk. It was about an ideal trade. Intraday, good. I had to skip it a night later, even 2 nights later, and quickly close it when I already saw a short pattern. Descending triangle, pressure towards the level. There was also a sale throughout the market. I quickly exited. This deal brought me, what, $210, but not so much now. I was not sitting there with a tenth shoulder, but nevertheless, $210 in my pocket. Let's look at this thing. Not positions, yes, but P&L to the patron. Here it is, P&L and closed positions, order history, take profit, stop loss. We'll see. Well, you see what I have after all. It was possible to take profit, but I cancelled it. Cancelled the time of the order. It doesn't write on the date of cancellation, so okay, I ended up closing. No, by the way, wait, did I really move the stop loss to 10,713? That's not it, I just cancelled the order, closed myself manually. I remember closing by market. Before we go any further, let me remind you that there is a link in the description to register on Exchange B. I switched to it from Binance, transferred such demo accounts, well, relatively speaking, the ones I'm showing now. I also transferred my working account. Interestingly, upon registration, they will actually give you $100.
Из интересного, при регистрации вам дадут $100 реально.
There's no demo, no real dollars. If you make a deposit of $3 and make a trading volume of 6,000, a trading volume of 6,000 is just a buy and sell of any coins for $3. That is, you deposited $3, bought a Bitcoin, sold the Bitcoin, and now have $3. Well, there's a couple of dollars of commission you'll pay for it. You can get $100 from the link in the description. This is the top one exchange, except for Binance. There's also a link to Binance below. There's cashback from referrals. You can take it on an infinite commission, but Binance is not suitable for users. From Russia, that is, who is from Russia with a Russian passport, Bybit is the top two exchange for you. It has essentially the same conditions, with the same commissions, a little less liquidity, but here's a welcome bonus of $100. It's beautiful. For those who have large balances, if you have $250,000 there, for example, you can get up to $30,000 as a registration bonus. Well, $100 is guaranteed. Anyone can get it. Well, yes, conditionally anyway. If you're running a small account, of course you won't initially deposit 3,000, but you'll still agree with 3. It's a fairly small amount that many people have. Well, let's move on. The next trade was on ADA. It is unprofitable. It deserves special attention. It is also exemplary. It is also good. I show why there was a loss. Why do I say that it is good? When you trade, here I explain for complete beginners, you will always have unprofitable trades. That is, does not happen that all of a trader's trades are positive. Well, this simply cannot happen. And losing trades, they are divided into several types. Trades that you made outside the system that you shouldn't have made. Trades are bad. And there are trades that you made exactly according to the rules, but sometimes they lead to a loss. Okay, so this is another transaction that was clear according to the system. Of course, it had a good entry point, but lead to a loss. This sometimes happens, the price does not always go in favor of the trader, and so what happened here was a short deal of 5 minutes on ADA. The next deal will also be an ADA and also on a 5 minute break with a short break. Now, let me immediately open it on TradingView, and the market was quite strong at that moment. I also took a long position from the level that happened here while interacting with students. There was a high level of volatility, the volumes were sold, and the price dropped. So it's in a flat, then the whole market was also in a flat, and ADA was one of the first to go out. And the only disadvantage of this transaction was that I was making a purchase here despite the rest of the market. Well, that is, I was looking at the whole rest of the market, but there was no power there. According to ADA, one of the few coins, there was power and risk when you enter into a trade in a conditionally strong market, but when it is so semi-sluggish. But the coin is strong and you follow the trend. The risk is that not the entire market begins to move there towards this coin, which went first. But the coin can follow the rest of the market, which is so semi-sluggish. In this case, the deal was good in general, but occurred in a sluggish market. Then the sideways level exit from the sideways, exit from the level and stop loss just beyond the lower edge of the sideways where I was actually closed. That happened instantly. They arrived there even settled, but no, the market didn't go. ADA also rolled down and closed me down. Such a simple, ordinary, everyday, ordinary transaction that didn't work with a slight minus in terms of the fact that I entered without confirming the strength of the entire market. Here I was hit by a stop. This actually took away $200. Let me remind you that if I had eaten $200 from the original balance and 250, there would have been nothing left of the balance at all, but I could already afford such a stop because I already oversold the account. Please note, it was 300 plus 400 plus 200, that is, it was already 900 and I lost 240. And those people who trade on a large account, for example, you have not $900 there but $900,000, you look at this and think, if I had $900,000, I would have entered into the same deal. $240,000 would have eaten me up. This is complete horror, obviously, because you don't take such a risk on large accounts, which you can afford on a small one. On a small account, 240.
Можешь позволить себе на маленьком. Да, на маленьком счете
$900, a loss of $240 is a considerable part. But such a risk is inevitable if you wish to expand your account. You must take significant risks, as I hinted at. This is a minimal risk within a small account. $240, a standard stop for such a balance. If we want to amplify it, we can set $40 stops for sure. Make 80 secret ones, but that would lead to a considerable number of trades with bad outcomes. You wait for a better point of entry, as a result your statistics suffer. You waste more nerves, the end result in rare cases improves. At least similar outcomes will be received in comparison to numbers, but it exhausts your nerves. As I said, there will be numerous passing trades, often even deposits are lost on such notions, and you should not be afraid to take relatively high stops. But this is not a high stop. For such a balance, $240 is fine. It's a normal stop. Let's move on. Regarding ADA, I lost $240 on this trade. What happened? The long squeeze occurred, it affected the whole market, a very clear bottom pattern was formed here, similar to the one in 2018, during the day for Bitcoin, a very similar situation, and what happened? A double bottom appeared, the bottom level, we went lower, refreshed this bottom, the third downward level, well to be clear. The longs just got squeezed, here they are descending, another descending one, now the descending ones are over, that is, you can already see here, there was a double bottom level, the price went up, I placed it, at this moment it was happening, I placed a strong level after the breakdown of which should take off, this was the level of my stop, the stop here was small, after this trade with a relatively high stop, I decided to go long.
Стоп здесь был небольшой. После вот этой вот сделки с относительно высоким стопом я решил
with a smaller stop so that it doesn't eat up a lot of money again if an identical situation arises and what resulted in the end. I hadn't bought here yet. I waited for the perfect moment where my buy was and waiting for the retest. They tried to move beyond the level, didn't work. They sold out. This is a false exit, false breakthrough, another false breakthrough. They broke through for the third time, gained a foothold, retested the level for a retest of the level with a stop here, a small short stop, a clear understandable trade. The price went right away. Here I closed my hands and it was like walking on a throne. I saw a sale, saw a triple top, a downward pattern, a rounding of the trend. I didn't wait. Theoretically, it was possible to just move the stop here to a plus, but I didn't wait for it. I just closed with my hands, and everything was left with a profit. Well, if I had been stopped out too, I would have earned a little less in the end. These are four trades that allow me to increase my balance to almost $1. I now have a little less than $1. Here are my positions. You see, I have a patron in position, $984 margin. This is my entire balance, that is one more rule. With a small account, you enter the entire balance with leverage, of course. In this case, I have the third leverage on the throne because the risk on this transaction would be...
Обязательно. В этом случае у меня третье плечо по трону, потому что риск на этой сделке выше, чем вот на той же Аде, например. Здесь я, по-моему, тоже десятое брал. Давайте посмотрим.
Here it is a negative trade, here it is a positive trade, a close position. You can calculate the quantity. I'll also show you the order history. You can pause it if you want. If anyone is interested in looking at the numbers in detail, look at it in detail, but I won't dwell on this so that there's no unnecessary delay. Let's now go to the throne, to my current.
Я на этом останавливаться не буду, чтобы там ролик на час не затягивать. И заходим теперь на трон, на мою текущую сделку. Что же по ней?
I shorted. This is a deal on a 4-hour frame, meaning the stop here is much higher in terms of percentage than for that Jade, for example, 7% stops. Because the deal is quite risky, I do not take high leverage, maximum is this third. Theoretically, it could have been possible to take the fifth, but there would have been enough of a good plus, but on this account, I still do not take super big risks. I do not want to, and accordingly, there will be a slow acceleration. If I took the 100th leverage, the deal would go through, everything is good, I would increase my balance from $300 to $30,000, but the likelihood that you enter and earn with a 100th leverage is not high. So let's say with the stop you wouldn't survive 7% and the deals there would be bad. In this case, everything is fine. The stop there is 6.7%, maximum third leverage, that's where I had an entry. You see this buy-sell, this is the pass. The deal to the patron I was showing was sat here, but I came in a little earlier. What's happening here? The market here is turning. I will release a review of what's happening with the market in the coming days. I will tell you about the likelihood of a correction. There's a high probability of correction on a 4-hour frame throughout the market.
Явно рисует нисходящий паттерн. То есть я когда показывал вам выход по трону, выход по аде, вот
подобный паттерн, я закрывал вот здесь. I opened my longs here, in this case, I opened a short. I was sitting without a deal, and if it falls, I don't fix my profit from my long here. I make money on this fall, so I entered here slightly in advance into short.
Вошел здесь в шорт чуть заранее. То есть в идеале здесь как входить?
Ideally, how to enter? Ideally, enter at a clear level. You need to enter here on the cutting charts, I can show you this. I have this moment marked right here. The ideal point for entry into short is here in the red zone. You could enter in advance if you do not wait for it to consolidate, but I entered before the breakdown of this level. Well, here the level is a little higher than what I just drew, and I indicated a more local level here. Yes, this is a false breakout of this level I entered.
В него, если вы не дожидаетесь закрепления. Я же вошел еще заранее, до пробоя этого уровня. Ну, тут уровень на самом деле чуть-чуть повыше у меня обозначен, чем я только что вам нарисовал. Я обозначил уровень такой более локальный вот здесь, да, вот это ложный пробой этого уровня.
A little in advance before the breakout of this local level, before the breakout of this global level, I am now in a short position, I will earn accordingly from the fall. As soon as we exit this pattern downwards, what's the risk? The risk is exiting this pattern upwards if the whole market becomes sharply strong. From here it goes up, I have a stop for the nearest level. Well, like for the nearest local one, of course you can also draw it here, but for me there is a stop for the nearest global level, and not close, not for the nearest low, and not far beyond the nearest strong zone, from which the last trade was made. Here is a good zone for take, I just installed my tech in it, and what do I expect from the deal? Let's look at the loss. Potential loss will be $193, this is a good number. From 1,000, only 193 is okay. It's because the leverage is small. Well, potentially the profit will not be super big, only $369, yes, I'll remind you. What did I do from 300 plus?
Ну и потенциальная прибыль будет не супер большой, всего $369, да, я напомню, что я от 300 сделал плюс 400.
Made an extra 400 on the first deal.
Могу сделать,
now I can do it for more. However, if the deal only goes to 369, why is that? That's because the leverage is small and the risk is high. The stop is large because the trade is on a high frame, and here you can put in a smaller stop. Of course, you can stick a stop here. It will be very small, but you need to let the price breathe. Another thing, when you accelerate the balance, don't forget that you need to let the price breathe. In other words, it should move a little against you.
Зайти в сделку, чтобы цена пошла ровно в вашу сторону сразу после входа. Бывает иногда такое, да, но редко. Надо дать цене немножко волатильности позволит. То есть, если вот такая штука произойдет, я стоп вот сюда поставлю, ну, меня 15 раз выбьет, и только потом сделка зайдет, а я, ну, может, что, перезайду здесь, что ли? Ну, нафига в эту же сделку перезаходить, если вот хрень уже какая-то пошла, моя идея не отработала. Я даже вот здесь бы уже перезаходить не стал, не говоря уже вот об каком-то вот этом моменте. Просто пропустил бы вот такое движение из-за того,
this
что
пожалуйста, взял там and больше took more leverage there. Маленький стоп, if потерял I had put бы там столько stop, же, I would have lost the same amount there on a small stop and would not have made money if the price went in my favor further. That is, you need to know the balance, the risk-reward, the risk of profit, and not chase millions at once.
Не гнаться сразу за миллионами, теоретически.
Theoretically, you can accelerate a small account there with $10 and earn big money. The best case in my training, Leosha can now subscribe to my Instagram. I showed it, and I think I will show it many times. I did from $500 to dollars, around $20,000, that is, it's possible. But you don't need to chase after it. That is, you don't need to think that with $300, I'll now earn tens of thousands at once. No, we're still accelerating, yes, but a little bit at a time. Remember that making X2 on a large balance in a year is great. You have $100,000. You made an extra $100,000 in a year. Everything is fine, normal, $100,000 is in your pocket. Some might think it's a little, but others they trade for a million. Want to make at least a million more, or someone has $100,000, but $100 is not enough. Wants to make money with these $100 million? Well, this is a more difficult task. Let's say for a small balance, making, I don't know, 10x in a year is generally simple, very easy.
И это сделать несложно. Сделать за месяц 10
and it's not difficult to do. Making 10x in a month is also possible, but extremely difficult.
Размеренно ищем
it's pointless to think about this anymore. We look for the best entry points, make the best deals, set stops correctly, manage risk and profit well. Remember that you need a trading system. A trading system is necessary. I anticipate questions. I know that not everyone watches my videos consistently. Many people visit the channel once a month, and someone who watches this video might not have seen my previous ones, or they're not subscribed to my other social media. I've mentioned training several times in this video. Someone may wonder, like, how can I get into training? No way, I occasionally do sets. This year there were two for training, and before that, I did something 3 years ago. If I recruit for the next training round, subscribe to my social media channels, I will announce it, but you can't just do it directly. It's impossible to take the course right now. I still have to plan my time and allocate it to teach people trading. And hey, don't forget about the $100 deposit bonus on Bybit at the link below. It may be more if you have a larger balance. Subscribe to the channel and my other social networks. They're listed below. Telegram and Instagram, I appear there more often, although I haven't posted much on Telegram lately, but we will continue in the near future.
Хотя в Телеграм я последнее время мало что выкладывал, но в ближайшее время продолжим. Удачи.